Paddleton is directed by Alex Lehmann. It's written by Alex Lehmann and Mark Duplass, and it stars Mark Duplass and Ray Romano. The two main characters of the film, played by Ray Romano and Mark Duplass, are these kind of lonely, quirky neighbors that also happen to be best friends and get together every once in a while to play their favorite invented game, Paddleton. Mark Duplass plays a character that is diagnosed with a form of terminal cancer, and because there's nothing he can do to cure it, he decides to end things before the sickness gets too bad and his suffering goes too far. His best friend Ray Romano is supportive and is there for him and follows him on this road trip to go get the medicine that will allow him to end his life. He's suffering immensely from the idea that he is going to lose his close and visibly only friend, but he also seems to be very angry at the fact that Michael, Mark Duplass's character, has basically decided to give up and is not going to fight this thing, to quote Ray Romano. And so the movie is not so much about a main character learning to cope with his own mortality, but rather a character that is learning to cope with the mortality of the person that he loves. So you've probably seen this film before, and I'm not gonna sit here and pretend that it's revolutionary or original in any way, but what it does have going for it is how just simple and small scale and sincere it is. The premise of the film is maybe reminiscent of something like 50-50, but whereas 50-50 felt quite obnoxious and artificial, there was something very true both in the relationship between the two main characters and just the film's perception of what death is. Paradoxically, 50-50 is actually based on a true story, based on the actual battle with cancer that the writer of the film went through, and Paddleton, I did a little digging, is apparently based on nothing. Now, this isn't to bash 50-50 in any way, but it is to evoke this strange idea, actually, that film and art in general, I guess, can feel so true and powerful and raw even when it's based in no reality, yet feel completely artificial and fake and even cliched while being based on real characters, while being based in the real world and based in the true lives of true people. It also does well, in my opinion, to not incorporate a lot of that Sundance indie quirk that maybe a younger writer-director team would have incorporated within the film, and just decides to play it straight. As a matter of fact, it's pretty much a straight drama. It's marketed as a comedy, and it does have some comedic actors, and while yes, there are some funny moments of levity and some jokes, it just feels very natural to the characters and their personalities and the film, and not so much like somebody went in there and said, oh, well, we've been a downer for 5 minutes, so let's add in a joke. And even that last sequence, it really doesn't pull any punches. It's hard and heartfelt and pretty heartbreaking, and is really not trying to shy away from what it is, which is somebody dying. And thankfully, it also doesn't go that horrible bucket list type route of, oh, well, I'm gonna die, so now I'm gonna do all the things that I never could do. You know, which would have made me want to kill myself faster than the character in the movie. Rather, it stays that very true, very humble route of, I'm gonna die, and I wanna spend the last few months of my life hanging out with my best friend, eating pizza, and watching kung fu movies, which, again, felt very real, very powerful, very true, and it also handily keeps the budget way down. So well done, Marky D, truly the indie DIY king. So as always, thanks very much for watching the video. Be sure to hit the like button and subscribe and comment if you want to add something in the comment section. And until next time, bye.